Code of the County of Spartanburg to change the period of impoundment for pet. Mr. John Harris is to present today.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Recommendation that we delete subsection D of County Code Section 6-6, and instead follow the state code, which is 47-3-60, that requires animals to be home for 5 days. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer those.
I think this is pretty cut and dry. If you have no objections, I'll go ahead and...
Any other discussion before Councilwoman Hall makes a motion?
I'm not on your committee. Can I just say one thing? I agree with James. I mean, we got to do what we got to do. But I would encourage the chairman, you know, after this vote, because I think we're at a crossroads with the Humane Society. We've had a great partnership with them. I think we'll continue to have a great partnership with them. But I think we're at a crossroads, especially with that facility and the demands it's going to place on them, with the size and the cost implications. And I would encourage the chairman to form a committee, maybe the finance chairman, and Michael, and maybe O'Neill as Public Works, because I think it's going to tail all three of these departments. Where we work with the Humane Society, Chairman Darwin Simpson, I think, is the new chairman coming on board, and quickly meet with them and come up with a solution for all of us. And that's just a suggestion, Mr. Chairman.
We've had two bad hogs in the past.
And I don't think we have but weeks to get this thing worked out. And I think everybody would do it too.
All right, Ms. Hall.
Yes, I'd just like to add that as council chairman has just alluded, we have had two ad hoc committees that have investigated and tried to work with the Humane Society on several issues. I don't consider either one of those committees to have been successful. So if there's a new frame of thought with Spartanburg County Humane Society, then I'm for us moving forward and working out a relationship. With that said, I make a motion to accept this and deal with the first reading.
Then probably move to second.
Second.
All in favor, present this full council. Let it be known as aye.
Aye.
The second item to come before the committee is to receive information and take desired action in reference to the coroner's office vehicle. We have Mr. Rusty Clevenger, our coroner, present.
Mr. Chairman, in March this year, I approached full council about two part-time positions. At that time, I made the statement to council that I did not think either one of those vehicles needed to be a take-home vehicle for one of the investigators. Coming back before council to seek at least one of those vehicles or one of those vehicles, not both, just one because of equipment issues, my investigators experiencing a majority of the equipment they require is in those vehicles. And she's running into problems that she needs either on scene or at the morgue to be able to collect evidence that's usually kept in those vehicles. And we're running into a major problem. She's worked since the 1st of August when she was sworn in, close to 40 cases already for us and been a major help. But she's being kind of impeded by the lack of equipment. She carries very basic equipment in her vehicle, which she is driving. So I'm seeking this basically full council support and her being able to take that vehicle to her residence. There's a strict policy within my office that they don't drive the vehicle unless they're on call, and it'll be to and back and forth from her residence to work.
Okay, and this will directly relate to her being on call?
Yes, sir.
In personal time. But I don't think this will fall under the purview of any ordinance. I think we can take direct action. So at this point, I'll entertain a motion as far as Mr. Clevenger.
I'd just like to clarify, maybe Rusty, ballpark off the cross street.
Okay, I've had the shop run the numbers. That vehicle costs 13 cents a mile to operate. Total cost for that vehicle was 26 cents a mile. If I had to pay mileage, which currently is 55 and a half cents a mile, that's cutting everything in half, what I would have to pay as far as that. Now, her round trip to her residence is 15 miles. We're talking about a round trip of 15 miles per day, and she works an average of 4 to 5 days per week.
Okay. Mr. Chairman, at this time, I'd like to approve.
I move to second. All in favor, please, you know, by
aye.
Okay.
And last question we have in our packets, obviously, is the building code department. That's all the information that's come towards the end.
Thank you. The items on the land use, public works, honorable chairman, Dale Tucker, state of Benton, members, committee.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have one item for today. The procedure information takes entirely as a reference to an ordinance submitted in the Parker County Code, Chapter 66, solid waste management, as amended to assure the compliance with solid waste management plan. Jim Hill and Jason Weaver, if you present, I believe Jason's probably going to be the one to present. Is that correct, Jim?
I can, in the interest of time, I can do it. Jason can support me if you're okay with that.
Go for it.
Jason and his cohorts presented to you the plan for our solid waste at your last meeting, and you approved that plan based on their recommendations. And as we have evaluated the implementation of the plan, we have discovered that there's really no code that covers us as we try to assure compliance with our solid waste management plan. In the suggested addition to Chapter 66 of the Spartanburg County Code, we need to recognize that we're only talking about solid waste. It is not, we're not talking about hazardous or infectious waste as defined by the state of South Carolina, because state rules prohibit us from doing so under this venue. And I should point out, as you look at the proposed language of this addition to Chapter 66, that our land use staff is also looking at our land use management ordinance as it complies to solid waste and other waste facilities within the county. And they are reviewing language there to make potential recommendations for changes there to the planning commission and then come back to you. So, Mr. Chairman, you have the wording of the proposed addition to ordinance Chapter 66, Section 11, and we would recommend your consideration of that for the first reading.
Thank you, Jim. Any questions for anybody? If not, I understand the motion to...
Mr. Chairman, at this time, I move we approve first reading.
I'll second. And what this does, it gives us the ability to be proactive versus reactive.
That's correct. All in favor, raise your right hand, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Chairman. The full council work then for the 5:30 meeting, which starts in 1 minute.
Thank you very much, and that concludes our committee meetings. Thank you. Do we need just 3 minutes?
Yeah.
3 minutes, can